world's women's champion, the Banshee, Ellie Embers.
When it comes to the Banshee, she does like to pull her tricks. That there is a given.
Not for that thy former champion has mixed into a little bit of trickery amongst herself. For I shall now bask in the presence of all of you, for that I am now here as thy women's world champion. Now, but amongst other things, thou art a dire threat, which as to why I have amongst you, have returned my original form as the Banshee Queen. Many of thou believe that I hadst a play amongst the interview, the contract signing, the shenanigans, the charade, the abomination that happened 2 weeks ago, with Ellie Embers herself and Samantha Foxy. Thou art to believe that I had a play, a part of what happened on that night. And Samantha now believes that I was a jester. That is not my power. For what Samantha believes that I was the one who tricked her into believing that Ellie was all loyal. I'm afraid Samantha is pathetically blinded, for that it was not I who played the dark shrouded on her eyes. Mark my words, I hadst returned to this former self to protect your champion, your Ellie Embers, that there is a darker threat looming. A threat that Ellie deemed to believe that was eliminated. That a threat that everyone believed to be eliminated. And Samantha believes that it was all me, the Banshee Queen. But fear not, Samantha. All things will come to your eye. I see it. But at the matter of hand, it is not I who is the only threat for Samantha now. But I shall give Samantha a rematch. But until this dark threat is eliminated, Ellie shall not be at the helm of this vessel until I deem it to be vanquished and it is safe for Ellie to rise again. I shall be the opponent that Samantha shall face for her rematch. Besides, Samantha has now another threat for thy title, by which I mean the bird that is a swan, yond wears the color black.
I think we know who she's talking about.
Yup.
Yep, that one anomaly.
Yeah. The Banshee is talking about Brooke Owens. All I can see when I look in the mirror, I can't escape all these thoughts in my mind. They're waiting to haunt me night after night.
All right. I'm sure Brooke has a few words to say.
Oh, she's definitely got something to say about this.
Release the quagga!
Well, well, well. Isn't it Banshee, or should I say the vessel that Ellie Ambers hides behind? You see, Sam, as much as I respect her, she dropped the ball on her moment to shine last week. And honestly, she doesn't deserve a rematch. But me, on the other hand, I have nothing to lose and everything to gain. Remember this corner, Banshee? You may not remember it, but I know, Ellie, you know deep down inside what I've done to you in this corner, and what I can and will do again to take yet another championship from you. And Sam, she had her moment and she blew it, so if she wants to stand in my way, then by all means, consider this level of respect out the window because I want the FPW Women's Championship, and I Now what?
Oh, dear Lord. Who the?
Can you find me?
What?
I'm here. Where'd you go?
I know amongst the shadows who thou art. Just in time.
Don't be scared. I just want to play a game with you. Hey, don't you run away. Please stay. Stay with me. If you don't come play with me.
What in the hell?
Oh dear!
Who the hell was that?
Play a little trickery on thy as much as you want. I know who thou art, Brooke. Does this not prove to be enough evidence that it was not I who played the trickery on Samantha? Thou knows who that was, and time will tell whether if Foxy shall. Bite shadow with shadow, I shout, and Brooke, steel thyself and prepare for what is to come. Bright, I fear it won't just be not just you, not just Samantha, but a third besides us three.
What the hell is with all these rules?
Ready, the four horsewomen of apocalypse!
What in the...
That was creepy as all fuck.
Yes it was. I'm just like, what in the... What's with all the riddles? What's with the creepy stuff going on here? But may have waited until Halloween for the creepy things?
No, I don't think they can wait till Halloween.
I couldn't agree more with you, Brooke, just thinking, okay then.
I mean, we had Samantha just disappear like a freaking ninja.
Okay then.
Ladies and gentlemen, the pride of Scotland, Charlie Duffield!
All right. That's enough. Let's cut the music. Okay. So, for those of you that were here about a week ago on for Uncensored before 93 Van Gilno, I came out here and I was nice. I was trying to offer some advice to our European men's champion. Now, evidently, he took my words the wrong way, and he thought I was challenging him to a match. So I thought, why not? If he wants to do it that way, why not? If he wants to ignore my advice, why not? Get him in the ring, let's teach him a little lesson, and let's make this a bit of a costly lesson, shall we? How about we make this a European title match, right here, right now? Like you say, Leviathan, when you come down, put your belt on the line.
Oh my.
Oh wow. I mean, it is true. Charlie Duffield did come out here and he was quite nice to Leviathan, trying to give him some advice.
Well, I don't know why Leviathan took it as something completely different, but yeah,
it happens, you know. Well, I guess asking you shall receive.
Seems so.
Well, we're waiting for Leviathan to get out here.
Come on, where is he? Well,
that's a good question. Where the fuck is he?
Your guess is as good as mine on that, Charlie?
And maybe I need to go back there and teach him a lesson. Leviathan?
Wait. What the? This can't
What's
be Leviathan. What the hell?
Are you serious?
Son of a bitch. Chester again?
A grudge with both of us, Trixie?
You mean the one that said he wants to hurt my little Felix?
Yeah, then had the nerve to call me a douchebag or something?
I guess so. But seriously though, I would
you know
have
what?
No problem.
You know what? I have no qualms with Charlie beating his ass.
Neither do I. Like I said, if I could, I'd be letting Felix have fun using him as a scratching post.
John, you know what? I appreciate having a fan, but this whole stalker thing you got going on, you gotta do something about that, pal.
Stalker? stalker, oh my goodness.
No. I'm not done proving my point just yet.
What?
I'll tell you this. Biased ass commentaries over there. I didn't even have brass knuckles on me. That's a lie.
What? I didn't say anything about that.
And Nicole, come on. You didn't see anything.
Oh, wait a minute. I know what you're talking about.
I'm sorry, continue.
I was gonna say this. Just one thing before I let you finish. I know you called out Leviathan out here, and he was on his way out. But he ran into a little accident. I hope his brain isn't on the bottom of my boot, but, you know.
AKA accident.
Accident my foot.
You know what? I came here for the fight. I don't care who the hell I fight.
Ooh. Damn.
Yeah, just ring the bell.
I think that's all we can do here, and hope that JD doesn't have any brass knucks on him this time.
It wouldn't surprise me if he somehow has snuck him in.
Yep. I will not be shocked if this ends in some kind of controversy.
Ooh.
Damn, what a clothesline.
Yeah, that's gonna hurt. Oh boy. Seems like some people in the audience are very eager for Charlie to kick his ass. There's a pin for one, and... No, it's only different one.
Yeah.
Oh, man. This is just all kinds of crazy.
This whole night is all kinds of crazy already.
Well,
I knew something was gonna go wrong.
Did you really have to rake the eyes?
It's John Dennis we're talking about here. He's...
Ah, yes, John Dennis. It's like, hey, look at me. I'm the greatest thing since sliced bread.
I'm the greatest thing since a free lunch with chocolate milk. They have chocolate milk now?
Anyway, he's really going up with quite a good bit of punches on Charlie.
Meh. Yes, it is.
And now Charlie's bounced off the rope, but oh.
Okay, I have to admit, that was a good drop kick.
I guess. But still doesn't change the fact that John Dennis is an asshole.
Oh, he's a real asshole.
And the crowd could easily agree on this one.
Yeah, watch him. He's not gonna argue with the ref. Here comes the ref argument.
Why is he not gonna argue with the ref? Anyway, he's going in for the pickup on him. Ooh, and in with a kick right to his guts.
You know what, just a little more and that would have been a kick to the nuts.
Oh! Looks like it's time for a good old LaBelle lock.
Little LaBelle lock, little bit of an old platter-like maneuver! That's what a LaBelle lock is, actually. It's kind of an old platter.
Mm-hmm. Oh, goodness.
If you know your MMA submissions, you know what that is and where it comes from.
Oh, looks like he has the ropes.
Eh!
Yeah, you should have held on to it just a little longer for this butt munch to feel more pain.
Just a little more damage.
But, hey, rules are rules.
Hey, Charlie's gonna fight honorably here. That's...
I mean, of course, it's always good for him to be honorable about it.
Already, it's a win in my book.
Exactly. Ooh. And now he's delivered a kick right to John on that one. Ooh. And a belly-to-belly suplex, too. Oof. But one thing for sure, he's probably going to be eating the words that he was just saying to Charlie. But first, he must deal with an elbow right to the knee.
Oh, yeah.
Seriously, dude. Why do you put yourself in these situations? I agree with you, Charlie. He's a rude so-and-so.
You know, I would just call him what he is.
Ooh. And yeah. Death Grip has just clotheslined him. John Dennis right over the ropes.
Right over that turnbuckle, right over the ropes, out of the ring.
He's a huge donkey! I love it!
Well, he is making a huge donkey out of himself sometimes. Anyway, now Charlie Duffield is outside of the ring. Oh boy. Oh! But it seems like GD was ready to deliver some pain to Charlie Duffield.
A spine buster.
I just hear Charlie yelling, son of a... Uh-oh. I think he's gonna fly. Ooh, yes. I was right. He went in with a somersault poncha. Man, I'm hearing a lot of boos and people just calling him a donkey.
And people hate John Dennis, and with good reason.
Of course.
Son of a female dog.
That's a very classy way of saying it, so...
No, here's the thing, that's an insult to a female dog in this case.
Yes, we know, he's indeed a huge donkey.
I think that's an insult to a donkey.
It probably is. Anyway, he tried to go for the pin, but it was only good for a 2 count.
And here it goes again!
You mean the fact that he's bitching about something?
Yep. And here comes the ref argument.
I just hear him saying, really? Ooh.
And he's gonna get pounded right in the face.
Yeah. To quote someone, he crossed the line this time.
Jelly should have beat his face in longer.
Yeah, I know, but you said so yourself. He wants to fight honorably.
Let me tell you something. After a while, honor gets thrown out the window.
Sometimes it does. And you're saying he's cheating? That's a load of baloney. But anyway... Oh, and Charlie's saying, I'll show you cheating.
I don't care, I tell you what, let this go! And again, right now I've got a bias towards Charlie and I know it.
Yeah. But anyway, Charlie has got John Dennis.
Somebody put him in a figure eight deathlock.
Oh, that would be Very, very painful.
Sharpshooter! Sharpshooter!
Ooh.
Big sharpshooter!
Well, he's definitely gonna be feeling that pain. And I just...
Hey, Charlie, put all that weight on his back! Every bit of it!
Of course, I just heard him saying to just tap and give up, but... I think with the fact that... Well, I would say he's stubborn as a mule, but that'd be offensive to mules.
It would be. And there's a difference between stubborn as a mule and being an ass.
Mm-hmm.
Which one do you think fits John Dennis right now?
Probably the latter.
Exactly.
Oh, and Charlotte is now picking him up from behind. Oh, wait. I didn't notice that Charlie had him by the hair. Whoops. Ooh.
Wait a second!
Come on, are you serious?
What the fuck?
He hit him in a place where the sun don't shine.
Did he just kick him right in the nuts?
Yes. Yes, he did.
That should be an instant DQ.
Oh, and he's going in for the pin. One, two.
Wait, no, he's got the tights!
What? I didn't see that.
I did!
Son of a bitch.
You know, I'm pissed off! I'm not even announcing this.
I don't blame you.
Like, first I kick right to the nads and then grabs the tights? No way.
This guy just does not know how to fight fair. Remind you of a certain group around here?
You may not use brass knuckles, but that's just as bad.
Yes. This is... No, I don't think this is how legends are made.
No.
Dude, you are full of shit. We all saw you hit him right in the nuts. What do you want?
We hope you're enjoying today's show as we take a moment to thank all of our amazing partners. Hello Gorgeous, one of the best bento pose stores in Second Life. Check them out for all your pose needs. Death Row Designs, for all your gothic and post-apocalyptic needs as well as fantasy clothing and accessories. Smart Tees, the official supplier for merchandise for Fusion Pro Wrestling and many of your favorite wrestling brands. Valkyria, for your role-playing and fantasy needs. Also available for custom work from wrestling gear, personal logos, and fully made mesh buildings. The Bearded Guy, your top source for backdrops, decorations, and accessories. Join the group today for discounts and store credit. NMA Wrestling Gear by Natalie Sonnen. Wear what the top fighters on the grid do combat in.
Oh, wow. I got into a rush due to that, and I'm like, yeah.
Oh, wait, you see that? Xur is following along.
Well! Vivian Payne and Miss Zora, ladies and gentlemen.
Greetings, my little masochist. I felt we had to come out here and address what had happened at 90s Rewind. Yes, it was embarrassing to lose against a couple of idiots like Shimmer, also known as Dumb and Dumber. Mizer and I are very talented women, but I feel like we need to place a blame on Mizera. Mizera, this was really all of your fault. You always try to take control instead of following my lead. You don't listen to that weird voice in your head that tells you to listen to me. So because of you, we lost, and I am so ashamed and embarrassed by the whole thing.
Ooh. Oh, hello.
I think someone's pissed. It's my fault? No, I said specifically, let me have one of them. But you kept on and ignored my command. If you tagged me, they both would have surrendered. Also, the fact that the Shogun told me to destroy you and them had nothing to do with your loss. You shoved me aside and refused to be told what to do. What the?
Wait.
Uh-oh. Huh? This is...
What's going on?
Probably the monkeys in the back messing with things again.
Has to be.
Alright.
Oh, wait, look.
May I intrude you two ladies for a moment? I got a special announcement. And plus, it's not like you two are dealing with me, anyways. Alright. The proof was with Shimmer. All you two did was make it a four-way. Instead of sniffing each other with petty nonsense that was shown in that match. That's put the hand bone commentating in the middle of the ring called the Shogun. Like, seriously. But anyways, with me losing Mizra, I'm kind of lost where I can go from here. Should I agent force anyone out back? Or should I make things hard for you, both of you?
Nope.
Who knows? But for now, I gotta get things done for us, chase the sun. But then, hope you two can, you know, stop pushing each other like... playground idiots. Or children at playground.
Mama, you're so pathetic. Move on and get over it.
I guess we're gonna go backwards a little bit here. Coventry, West Midlands, England, standing 5'6", weighing 8 stone 4 pounds or 116 pounds. The mom's and dad's favorite horse is Morrissey. I don't know anymore.
I don't know if the mom and dad's favorite thing is now. But wait a minute.
Her opponent disappeared out of here like a ninja.
I was about to say.
So they found somebody?
No, I guess not. I don't think horses heard of the fact that someone did a vanity check on us.
From Asylum City, Central Europe, standing 5'9", weighing 181 pounds, Samantha Foxy! She never shows up.
Oh, great.
What? Dang, she must have went far.
Yes, horses?
Yeah, what's going on? We don't know. She disappeared like a ninja.
She just poofed.
Yeah, gone.
Even the people in the back don't know where the hell she is.
Yeah, we've already, like we haven't tried to inquire.
Oh, boy. The match hasn't even started yet.
No bell is rung. The ref can't count if the bell isn't rung.
I don't blame you for reacting like this. Nope, don't you dare touch the bell.
Okay, referee is counting.
Oh, for crying out loud. Horses did. That's who rang that bell. Well, let's... I guess there's your winner via a count-out.
Yeah, Horses Morrissey.
Probably one of the most anticlimactic things ever to happen. And the crowd can easily agree with us on this.
What's my quack button? You know what, everybody start quacking.
We hope you're enjoying today's show as we take a moment to thank all of our amazing partners. Bespoke Caravan, mercenary artists at your service. We live and die by the brush. You are our most prized work. Fallen Kiori Star is a custom scripting consultant and bot development provider. Contact Fallen Kiori for any projects you need. Cerberus Crossing is a Second Life store that creates modern and eccentric original mesh creations. Women's Pro Wrestling Federation. Catch their shows every Saturday at 6 p.m. SLT. Over the Edge Wrestling. Catch their shows every Sunday at 10 a.m. SLT. Battle Championship Wrestling. Catch their shows every Tuesday at 3 p.m. SLT. Premier Wrestling. Catch their shows on YouTube.
You know, Vivian called these two idiots, but I don't think that's true. There's a reason these two are the women's tag champs.
Exactly. Hi, everybody. So good to see you again. Let's hear you make some noise.
You heard them, everybody. Make some noise.
We are so happy to be back here after 90s Rewind, where we had our first tag team title defense against Vivian and Nazura.
And what a defense it was.
Indeed. Let me tell you, though. I wasn't so sure if we were going to pull through since Nazir beat me in a singles match, like, 2 weeks ago before the FPV. I was feeling the jitters real good before the match, but my partner right here just said, let's have some fun. And the jitters went away because I knew, win or lose, it would be a great match. Well, technically she's not wrong.
Not at all.
And really, what else can you hope for but a great match, really? Right, V? Right you are, Maddie. Win or lose, we always want to show how it's done in women's tag team wrestling. Mazur and Vivian, they certainly did give us a run for their money, and they're even a hint of tag team cohesiveness between them. However, they just weren't able to get it done this time around, and we're still your FPW Women's Tag Team Champions. How do you like that? Natty, I don't know about you, but I'm about ready to whistle like a missile to chase the sun. Yeah, one sec. Hey, what the heck is your problem? Excuse me, is there something we can help you with? You got something to say? Say it to my face. Wait, what? What's going on?
Sorry about your face!
What the hell?
What? Wait, whoa, whoa, what the hell?
Hey, what the hell? You two get
out
of
here. Wait a second! Is that...
Who are those two?
That's a... Oh my god! Oh my god! That's a Satsu!
Oh, hold on a second. I just hear Noah sing. You feel a froggy, Hisatsu? Come on and jump.
Yeah, that's Hisatsu. I know who they are.
Oh no, poor Natty. She's like, ow, my nose.
I know exactly
Natty,
who
okay?
they are.
I don't know. Is it broke? Oh shit, you're bleeding. Uh-oh. Come on, let's get you to the back.
I hope they get to the back safely. Oh my god. Trixie, I know who those two are.
Who are they? Tell
okay,
me.
Okay, they are Hisatsu. They are the current tag team champions over at WPWF.
What's their reasoning for being over here, though?
I have no idea why they're here. And I'll tell you right now, Chiyoko cusses like a sailor. No, worse than a sailor.
I see. Anyway, I think it's time for the main event, folks.
Yeah, let's get to it.
Oh my god, seriously, I'm sorry.
What?
I think I need help
or
something.
Yep, it is. Ladies and gentlemen, this is your FPW Allegiance main event of the evening. Introducing first, from Calgary, Alberta, Canada, weighing 218 pounds, standing 5 feet 11 inches tall, Nitro Kicks!
Oh boy. This should be interesting. Yeah, he's He's definitely lost something. I just hear Nitro saying, tonight is my moment.
I mean, ladies and gentlemen, this is going to be a non-title match, but still, this could be huge one if he could win this.
What do you mean Shiryu isn't the champion we deserve? Yes, he is.
I mean, he knocked out a Neon Shadow, for Christ's sake. Not just ripped off his mask, but knocked him out.
Yeah. Speaking of...
And his opponent from Little Tokyo, Los Angeles, California, standing 5'10", weighing 240 pounds, he is the current FPW Men's World Heavyweight Champion, the Bad Boy Shiryu!
Well, yeah, obviously. Alrighty then. Now we have both of the competitors in the ring.
Oh, looks like it's time to get this match underway.
Oh, indeed. And there's the bell.
Two gentlemen not rushing into anything here.
Oh, it looks like Shiryu is definitely prepared for a fight. Ooh.
And Nitro kicks with the hammerlock on the champion.
Oh, and
headlock takedown.
Oh my goodness.
Wait.
What the?
We got a little bit of chain wrestling going on here.
Interesting. Ooh. Ow, ow, ow.
Well.
Uh-oh. Now he's got him in a waist lock. Hey, what the? Come on. Uh-oh. Oh no, oh no. He's got him in a chin lock. Not good. Not good. Yeah, I think I have... It's funny how I have to agree with what some of the fans said. I think Nitro's definitely got some screws loose.
Well, I mean, screws loose or not, he's still very talented in the ring.
I know that, but... I don't know. Anyway, he's going for a pin, one. No. It was only good for a one count on him. Now he's bouncing off the ropes. Ooh. Well, that came back and bit him hard in the ass.
Very hard indeed.
Anyway, Nitro is now bouncing himself right off of the ropes.
This will nip up there by Nitro. Oh!
Ooh.
Nip up there by Nitro Kicks! I mean, not Nitro Kicks, but Shiryu! Alright, who let the goats in?
I don't know. It's like no matter what, the goats always follow. Anyway, he's going for pin one. But no. He was only able to get a one on Shiryu.
Who let the goats in?
Hey, let's not ask dumb questions, okay?
You're right.
Anyway, Nitro is now throwing Shiryu right into the ropes. Ooh. That was one hell of a leg sweep.
Did Shiryu just get up from that?
I don't know. Oh, wait. Looks like Nitro has now got himself inside of the front guillotine. And Shiryu's... Ooh.
Now those shoot kicks.
Ow. Did he just gouge his eyes?
Yes, he did.
Bad. Oh, and I just hear Shiryu saying, "You ain't shit." Oh. Talk about people spitting venom. Ooh, and looks like Shiryu went in with a jawbreaker and then a Muay Thai spin back kick. Ooh. And then a headfirst takedown. Nice.
Very nicely done there by the champion.
And now he has thrown Nitro kicks right into the ropes. Or, I'm sorry, I mean the corner.
For clarity here, Shiryu is the champion.
Yes.
And it. Oh, Nitro kicks with a huge elbow out of that corner.
Well, I think at some point Shiryu is going to be seeing those Tweety Birds.
But that might have woke him up.
Maybe. And now Nitro is tossing Shiryu right into the ropes. Oh!
Oh, what a victory that!
Oh, I can only imagine how painful it is to get hit with that. Oh! And also a dropkick, too. And now Nitro is throwing Shiryu right into the ropes again. Oh! He went in with a spinning back kick. And a side effect, too. If only we knew what exactly those said side effects were. Anyway, here's a pin. One, two. No. It was only good for a two count, folks. I'm sorry. Anyway, Nitro's going in for the pickup. He gives a kick right in Shiryu's gut. Bounce off the ropes, but it goes. Someone goes in with a hard elbow strike. And, wow, he's just throwing them blows, isn't he? Now he's bounced off the ropes yet again. Ooh! And a float over neck breaker. Nice. Now Shiryu's bouncing off the ropes again. And a low rider bounce. Great, now I'm starting to think of that silly song of... Never mind. Pin, one, two... No. Nitro was able to kick out at the very last possible moment with that. Oh man, I'm sure Shiryu's just getting a little peeved off with Nitro here. Oh, he's going in for the Ultimo combo! Damn. And he is down. Uh-oh. And it looks like Shiryu's climbing right to the top of the ropes. As always, it's a make-or-break moment if you're up there. Oh! He tried to go in for something, but Nitro was able to get himself out of the way in time. And now Nitro's throwing Shiryu right into the ropes. Oh boy. Oh! And he is met with a drop kick. Ooh, Nitro is really delivering on those shoot kicks there. Ooh. And a spinning back kick too. And now he throws Shudio right into the corner of the ropes. Oof, boy. Ouch. 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 Ouch.
Big ouch.
Uh-oh. And now he's in... Oh. And that there was a snap suplex. Very painful move. Oh, now we're going to be seeing Nitro flying. I just hear him saying, it's over now. Oh!
Wow!
Looks like he that did more harm than good for him. Anyway, here's pin. One, two, no. He's only good for two. And Nitro's definitely getting a bit peeved off, even though this isn't a frickin' title match.
I don't know why he's getting so pissed off, I mean...
Ooh. And of course, he sadly got met with a bicycle kick. Oh, wait. I think Shudio wants to end this right now.
I think Shudio wants to say, oh my god, he's dead!
Maybe or maybe not. We don't know for sure. Now he's bouncing off the ropes. Oh, he missed. Oh, he's
got whoa, 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 whoa.
One, two, three.
What? No way! Ladies and gentlemen, your winner of this match, Nitro King! Nitro has just pinned the champion!
Nitro? I hate to be the bearer of bad news, but you're not the champion.
That was a non-title match, man!
Flickering therapy in the world to undo that.
You know, this has been a very, very weird night.
I know, right?
I mean, we got Samantha Foxy just poofing off like a damn ninja. We don't know where the heck she went.
Mm-hmm.
And then... later on, we have Shimmer coming out, but then we have an appearance from Hisatsu.